Hello, in today's lesson we continue to speak about the TouchDesigner SOP operators and particularly about the operations working with spline geometry. Today we're going to research the usage of bridge SOP, of profile SOP, of creep SOP and of the stitch SOP. So let's continue to the lesson. Let's start to speak about the bridge operator. In order to create bridges, we need some NURBS or spline geometries, including trimmed parts. So let's create the grid geometry. Let's make it on horizontal plane, ZX, turn it to NURBS. Let's split the view on left, right side and enable here the geometry viewer. So we have one geometry. Let's make some profile curve like circle. Also, let's turn it to NURBS, ZX plane, and reduce the radius. Now we can project profile curve using the project SOP. Okay, now in order to generate the projected curve, so now we see we don't have any projected curve. So we need either to move the circle on the distance in order to project using method along vector or just to choose the parametrically. And now we can see that in node info we have one NURBS surface and one profile. Now in order to make the trim, we can use the trim SOP. And voila, we have a trimmed geometry. So we can readjust the range in the project, so we can make it smaller. And let's use the copy SOP to make the second trimmed geometry. I will disable the grid and enable display flag on the copy SOP. Let's make two copies and move one copy on the vertical direction and rotate it a bit. And now we can use the bridge SOP to generate a bridge geometry. So you can see that we don't have any bridges right now. That's because we need to define which profile curves we want to bridge together. In order to see the profile curve numbers, we need to open the display options and enable the profile numbers. And you can see that profile numbers, they have quite strange numbering. 0.0, 1.0. So that's how we should define them in the group parameter. So 0.0 and 1.0. And now you can see that some bridge geometry was generated. Now we can go to the surface properties and check different options. So we can use curvature. In that case, it will continue the curvature of the tangents of geometry. We can control it by scaling tangents. We can scale curvature in both directions. And we can generate a circular arc fillet. So we have quite several options. That's how the bridge operator is working. So it's also dynamically rebuilding. So if I will rotate the copied geometry, you will see how the bridge SOP recreating the geometry. Also, that's maybe good options to check how the profile SOP is working. Let's create a profile. And using that operator, we can solve two tasks. One task, we can extract the profile curves. So let's disable display flag here and enable display flag here. So we can extract the profile. So for example, we can extract the profile number 0. We can change the divisions. We can keep the surface. We can change the tolerance. We can extract it parametrically to XY, so to vertical direction. And second option, we can remap. So that's mean basically the same operation if we would change the original project U and V range parameters. So we can go here and remap the position of the profile. Now let's create some small setup showing how to work with the creep operator. First, let's just make the very default basic setup. So I will create a grid geometry and turn it to splines. to NURBS. And also I'm going to create a sphere and also turn it to NURBS. Creep can project one geometry on the surface of the second geometry, so we can use it very easily like that, just connecting the first geometry and second geometry to project on. And you can see that we have the grid geometry projected on the sphere. Basically, we can change the size of the original geometry to see how it will change. Also, we can scale and move the projected geometry using the creep parameters. Like, we can control it using scale, and we can move it on the surface. And now let's create some more interesting setup, which will visualize more practical usage of the creep. Let's create a line. Let's make it longer, something like 5. And let's increase the amount of points to 200. Now we can make the transform copy of this line and move it by the y-axis a bit down. Now I will also create some text. For example, I will write the name of my project, How to Touch. Make it bold and make smaller size of the text. And I want to deform this curves by some function. For example, I can use the wave pattern. Let's make 200 samples, 199. Let's increase the period to make it something like that. And let's change the second period a bit so we have different shapes. Now I can apply that transformation to the curves by using the chop 2. And because I have only one channel, I want to apply it to the y-axis. I going to drop the wave to the chop. Then I remove tx, tz. And on the attribute scope, I remove p0 and p2. And I will rename that channel to ty. Then I rename the second chops channel also to ty. Copy and paste that. Reconnect to the transform one and drop here the wave 2. Now I can merge these two geometries, so I have the two lines. And I think, okay. The problem is that wave 2 overriding the ty positions, I can connect it directly to line 1. I don't need a transform. And in order to offset it, I can use the wave parameters offset and offset it in down direction. That looks even more intelligent. And now I have two deformed lines. In order to create a surface, I can use the skin SOP. Then I just will create the spline surface. Let's check that the geometry is now it's polygon, so I have to convert it to the spline geometry by using convert and convert to NURBS curve. And now I have one NURBS surface. And I can project or deform my text by using the creep. I connect it to here, I connect that to here, and I see what is happening. Now I can scale X to fit my text inside of the creep. Maybe I need to reverse the transform text before. Minus 1 and... So like you see, I can create quite interesting text animations by using this approach. And now if I animate the waves, just by animating the face, ups time dot seconds multiplied by 0.1, and the same here, I can make the animated deformed text. That's just another practical approach how we can work with the creep for the text animation. We can also reduce the amplitude. Next operator I want to show you is a stitch operator, and it's quite similar to the behavior of fillet operator we looked into last week. So let's just make a copy of the spline geometry I created in previous part. And now we have two splines, and using the stitch, we can stitch end points of the curves together. For that, we should enable the stitch parameter. We can also use tangents. Maybe let's resample and simplify these curves. Let's resample it to long steps, and let's convert them to NURBS again using fit. And now you can see we have a smooth geometries. Let's maintain the last vertex. And now we can correct the position of the stitch, so we can stitch the last points. We can also enable the stitch on the first points, and using the join we can actually convert them to one geometric piece, one line. This is quite easy. Thank you for being with me today. Next lesson we continue to finish to speak about the splines, and please go to the howtotouch.com and subscribe to our news to be updated about our free lessons, workshops, upcoming trainings, and increase your professional level. Thank you. Bye bye.